Hey guys, what's up? I'm Christian Taylor, and today I'm gonna tell you why you should stop using Google Maps and use Apple Maps instead. Now look, I never thought I'd be saying this. When Apple Maps was introduced in 2012, I did what I think any tech enthusiast did. And I was like, ha 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 ha, oh good luck. Apple thinks they're gonna beat Google and they're gonna make a Maps app. That's cute. But since its introduction in 2012, Apple Maps has continued to improve its reliability and accuracy, and it has become a legitimate alternative to Google Maps now, and I'm here to tell you why you may want to consider making the switch. So the biggest pro to Apple Maps is privacy. I got a little bit tired of Google constantly creeping on where I'm going. And in case you don't realize it, chances are you've already given Google permission to always look at your location even when you don't have the Maps app open. When I used Android, it would constantly check where I was, and it would have a timeline of my whole day, everywhere I've been that day, even if I didn't open the Google Maps app at all. This is creepy and uncomfortable because we have to remember that Google is an advertising company. So if I make frequent trips to Best Buy, you know they're gonna be showing me more Best Buy ads on my browser. And yes, while you can disable this on iOS and probably Android too, the way Google makes it, it's basically on by default. It was doing it even on my iPhone until I went in and purposely tweaked the location settings to take away permission from it. And that's just not something I'm a fan of. Apple is dedicated to your privacy and they don't track where you go. If they do, then it stays locally on your phone. There's probably some form of location history, but they're not saving it to their servers for years and years and using it for advertising purposes. So that reason alone, I think, is gonna be a huge reason for a lot of people to switch, just for more privacy and just to kind of break away from the Google overlord constantly stalking you. Number two is for Apple Watch integration, and this is actually what got me to try Google Maps and why I ended up switching. Yo, let me tell you something. It is really nice when you're driving to have a little tap on the wrist when it's time to turn. Your watch is just like, yo, and it taps you on the wrist. It's time to turn. It's time to like change lanes, homie. Get ready. The tap on the wrist is a little more precise than the audible instruction, so instead of it saying turn on blah 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 drive a while ahead and you're searching and you're saying, is this the street? You will know because probably 500 feet before the turn, your watch starts tapping your wrist and you're like, all right, I see the street, my watch is tapping, turn. Boom, done. Really improves navigation efficiency, and obviously if you're not an Apple Watch user, this makes no difference whatsoever to you, but if you do own an Apple Watch, I think using Apple Maps is a must. And the third reason, and why a lot of people probably use Apple Maps already, is, well, you can't change the default app on iOS. Now look, this is something I'm going to rip Apple for. I really wish Apple supported changing default apps. I don't think it's cool that they force their default apps on you through Siri or tapping stuff or whatever, but if someone sends you an address in the Messages app and you tap it, it's just gonna open in Apple Maps. So given Apple Maps has these other benefits, maybe you should use it instead of having to copy that address and go through this workaround to paste it into Google Maps just because you're so passionate about Google Maps. I mean, I know, I realize this argument is falling victim to what Apple wants you to do, and it's falling into their trap and just using it because it's easier. But I'm trying to say that since Apple Maps respects your privacy and has the awesome watch support, why don't you just use it? It's easier. Now look, Google Maps does have some advantages and some things I seriously miss. The first one is the navigation algorithm and the search algorithm. There's no doubting that Google is the king of algorithms, and they are much better at turn-by-turn navigation. I've had Apple Maps get me lost a couple times or kind of struggle, but Google Maps never misses a beat, and Google Maps is also far ahead of the game when it comes to searching for new places like coffee shops in the area or restaurants to eat at. Their search algorithm is just better at finding places. And the second advantage to Google Maps is reviews. So Google Reviews has built a huge reputation among everyone, really any user. You get mad at a place, you go on Google Maps, you leave a bad review. You love a place, you go on Google Maps and leave a good review. Google Maps has hundreds of thousands of reviews on almost any place, even local restaurants. And that's something Apple Maps just doesn't have. They do have Yelp integration, but Yelp's user base is much, much smaller, and there's no way to leave a Yelp review from the app. It just directs you to download the Yelp app, and then that's a separate thing you have to sign up for. And like I said, the user base on Yelp is much smaller, so there's no getting around the large amount of reviews that you get to access by using Google Maps. So I've kind of found this middle ground of using Google Maps to search for locations and leaving reviews, but using Apple Maps for navigation because of the watch integration and privacy. If you don't allow Google access to your location when the app is closed, you can get away with just opening it, searching for places at your leisure, leaving reviews at your leisure, but everything else with navigation or quickly looking at the map, you can do on Apple Maps. I've really enjoyed actually using both apps seamlessly together for their two different pros and cons. And maybe it's something you should do too if you have an iPhone. So what do you guys think? Should you continue to use Google Maps because it's the best maps app? Or would you like to give Apple Maps a try? I'd love to know your thoughts in the comments down below. And if you like this video, do be sure to hit that subscribe button and click the bell so you don't miss when I release new videos. With that said, I will catch you guys next time. And in case you're not in the know, Yelp is like the generic brand of reviews, where Google Maps is the name brand. That was a terrible analogy.